This time, ChargerLAB got the latest OPPO Find X7 Ultra. The box is designed with silver and black splicing. The name of the phone, Find X7 Ultra, is printed on the top of it. Compared with the OPPO Find X6 Pro, the appearance has not changed much. It has a large camera module. This enables it to support up to 6-fold optical zoom and 120-fold digital zoom. It has a 6.82-inch display that can support up to 2K. The display can automatically adjust brightness and color temperature to protect your eyes. In terms of hardware, it adopts a 3rd-generation Snapdragon 8 processor. The battery capacity is 5000 mAh, and it can support a charging power of up to 100 watts. It claims that it can be charged to 50% in 10 minutes and 100% in 26 minutes. And it's compatible with PD, QC, and UFCS protocols. It also supports 50 watts wireless charging and 10 watts reverse charging. What we got this time is the ocean blue version. As you can see, the upper part is white and the lower part is the blue of the ocean. The back panel is made of metal, eco leather, and glass. It comes with a 100-watt USB-A charger and a USB-A to USB-C cable. The USB-A port has the pin of proprietary protocol and widened pins for high current. Therefore, the cable is irreplaceable and must be stored well. The specs info of the charger is printed on the input end. Model is VCBAOBCH. It can support input of 200 to 240 watts, 50 or 60 Hz, 2.5 amp. And the maximum output is 5 volts to 11 volts, 9.1 amp. The manufacturer is all high. ChargerLab Power ZKM003C shows it can support UFCS, QC 3.0, VOOC, SuperVOOC, and DCP charging protocols. And it can support 3.4 to 5.5 volts, 3 amp, and 5.5 to 11 volts, 3 amp of UFCS. Next, let's test the charging compatibility. Use the original charger set to charge the phone. The real-time charging power is about 9 volts, 9 amp, 80 watts. The third-party chargers that support QC or PD protocol can reach about 17 watts. Third-party chargers that support UFCS protocol can reach above 20 volts. When charging with the original charger set, the current can reach up to about 9 amp. After switching to a third-party cable, the maximum current is only 3 amp, and the power is only about 23 watts. From this chart, we know that the lowest power can reach above 50 watts when charged with the original chargers. The power of third-party chargers is in the ranges of 9 watts, 17 watts, and 23 watts. It can also support wireless and wired reverse charging, but the power is not too high, so it is only suitable for charging devices such as headphones. After that, let's do the full charging test. We use the original 100-watt charger set to fully charge it. The voltage is always around 9 volts, but fluctuates. The charging curve can be divided into 7 parts. In the first part, the power was about 73 watts for the first 1 minute and 28 seconds. Then, the power gradually drops to 71 watts, 61 watts, 57 watts, 54 watts, and 46 watts in turn. The final part begins at 19 minutes, and the power slowly drops to almost zero. It takes 29 minutes to be fully charged. From this chart, it can be charged to 50% in 10 minutes, 80% in 18 minutes. It also reaches 100% in 29 minutes. The full charging time is close to what it claims. Next, we put them into a 25 degrees Celsius thermal tank throughout the temperature test, and record the highest temperature on the front and back after charging for 5 minutes, 10 minutes, and 20 minutes. After 5 minutes, the maximum temperature on the front is 35.6 degrees Celsius. The back is 38.1 degrees Celsius. The power is about 70 watts at this time. After 10 minutes, the maximum temperature on the front increases to 38.7 degrees Celsius, and the back is 39.1 degrees Celsius. The temperatures on the front and back have increased, and the power is about 54 watts at this time. After 20 minutes, the maximum temperature on the front drops to 36 degrees Celsius. The back is also 36 degrees Celsius. At this time, the power is gradually decreasing. We know from this chart that the temperature on the back is higher than on the front. The temperature is highest at 10 minutes, and the power is about 54 watts at this time. After 20 minutes of charging, the temperature has dropped to 36 degrees Celsius. It's only warm to the touch at this time, so the temperature control is pretty good. That's all charging tests for the OPPO Find X7 Ultra. The charging performance continues OPPO's consistent level. After testing, it only needs 29 minutes to be fully charged with a large capacity battery of 5000 mAh. With the original charger set, the charging power can reach up to 80 watts. However, after the charger set is replaced, the charging power will be greatly affected. It can be fully charged in short time through the private protocol. So we recommend using the original charger set to get a better charging experience. Okay, that's all for today's video. Please drop a like, leave a comment, and subscribe to us. See you next time. Bye!